Hey, what's going on, everybody? It's ETA Prime back here again with another LaunchBox tutorial. Today, we're going to be talking about auditing our LaunchBox collection or auditing our games. Now, this comes in really handy to manage your library when it comes to images, manuals, even names, LaunchBox database IDs. We can actually fix all of these issues quite easily using the audit feature built into LaunchBox. And we could do this with a single platform or we could do it with our full collection. Bringing up the audit menu with your full collection is going to be a bit confusing, I mean, especially if you've got a ton of games. So personally, I prefer doing it per platform. And in this video, I'm going to show you exactly how to use the audit feature. It's actually really simple to use. And for this tutorial, we're going to be going with my N64 platform. So once I have it highlighted, I want to go to Tools, and we have a section here called Audit. All games or the selected platform. I'm going to go with N64. It's going to scan through my games here, and it's going to bring up the audit menu. At first glance, it can be a bit overwhelming, but it's laid out quite nicely, and it really does allow us to kind of audit our games really easily. So we've got our list of N64 games, whatever platform you're going to audit here, alternative names, additional apps, application path, this is where our game or our ROM is going to be stored, date added, date modified, last played, if we have a duplicate, or if it's installed or not, region, developer, publisher, genre, series, status, play mode, max players, version, release date, release type, completed or not, our game music path, game manual path, and so on and so on. There's a lot to mess around with here, but you might have noticed that my first game on the list here is 007 GoldenEye 1, and I purposely imported it incorrectly to give you a little demo. Now, just going down the list here, alternate names. This is actually really cool. It'll give us alternate names from around the world per game, if any were available. So, for instance, Beetle Adventure Racing. If I choose this, we've got two extra names here. In Australia, this was actually called HSV Adventure Racing instead of Beetle Adventure Racing. In the States, we know these as Volkswagen Beetles. We've got another one here for Brazil, but I thought this was really cool, so we could kind of go through and just see what these games were named around the world. Now, getting into auditing these games is really easy, so we can actually just go through here and find out exactly what we need. This will tell us if we have a missing manual. My top game right here, like I mentioned, I purposely imported this incorrectly, doesn't show me the developer, publisher, genre, because the name was incorrect. It was an imported ROM, but we really have no extra metadata for this game here. And for our game manual path, I'll give you an idea on how this works. Obviously, we're not going to have a game manual for this top game, but we should for some of these that are actually blank. Now, you got to keep in mind that some of these aren't going to have manuals that we can automatically download. Like, for instance, Bassmasters 2000, I couldn't find a manual for that game. I don't know how well people have preserved all of the information on that game, but I know for a fact that Banjo-Kazooie should have a manual. So we're just going to right-click here. We're going to edit, media, download media, and from here it's going to scan the LaunchBox games database. So if we just take a look through here, no manual available, but if you do use EMU movies, there's possibly a manual ready to go, and it's actually listed right here. So I can uncheck all, or I could just leave everything checked, but the one I really wanted was that manual. So we're going to go ahead and download it. As you can see, automatically set up that game manual path for me. Choose OK. And now we've got that manual available for Banjo-Kazooie. Makes it really easy to find this missing media. And just going down the row here, you can see we've got the Wikipedia URL, more information, video URL, arcade cabinet images, which aren't going to apply to these N64 games, as well as arcade circuit board images, control panel, control. But if we go down a bit more, we've got our banner images, background images, box back, box front, and so on and so on. I mean, there's a lot to mess around with here, but the first thing I want to do is make sure I correct the information for this first game here, 007 GoldenEye 1. So that's not the correct name. We're going to right click. We're going to edit. From here, I'm going to go ahead and correct this title. So really what's throwing the whole system off is this one at the end. So I'm just going to go ahead and get rid of it. We can now search for metadata, and the LaunchBox ID has been found. As soon as we choose that, it's going to populate our release date, release type, genre, developer. Basically, all the information that we can get from that metadata is now populated with GoldenEye 007. Next up, we want to get our images. So I'm going to go to Media. I'm going to download Media. And I want to download as much as I can. So I'm going to check all. We're going to download from the LaunchBox Games database. I'm going to do this one more time because I do want to download everything from EMU movies also. We're going to download. Got that manual for me. Put it in the correct location. Choose OK. And now GoldenEye 007 is ready to go. So if I go down a bit, we can find it here. And all of this information is now populated. So as you can see, makes it really easy to audit your games. Now this can be a bit time consuming, but if you know for a fact that you've got a few games in a platform that need more information, you can always use this audit feature, and it does work out really well to help you manage your library. And another really handy feature we can do here is select multiple games. So let's say we've got a few here that need to be audited. We can hold Control or Shift and select these games. We'll just go with these four games here. I'm going to right click, edit, and this is going to bring up the bulk edit wizard. From here, we can choose Next, drop down, choose the field we'd like to change, broken. These four games are not broken, so I'm just going to make sure that this is unchecked. And this was just kind of a quick demo. I mean, there's a lot that we can mess around with from the bulk edit wizard. We'll go with Next. And once you're finished with that edit, it's going to ask you if you want to make more changes. But for this, I do not want to make more changes. So it's just going to close it down for me. Couple more little things here that come in really handy with this audit window. We can sort by column. So let's say we wanted to find all of the games in my Sega Model 2 section that don't have a LaunchBox Games database ID. If I just choose this, it's going to bring all of those up to the top, scans through all of them. As you can see, I've got two here. So I could actually edit these right now. Cyber Troopers, Sega Rally. Let's go with Cyber Troopers. Search for metadata. No games were found matching this title because it's actually a twin pack. Some of these games, you know, came in a twin pack. If I just want to remove this here, there we go. So we'll choose OK. And now we've got that sorted out. Another thing you might notice while doing an audit is a highlighted red game. This means I actually have a duplicate of this game. We can also use the column function here just to bring all of those duplicates up to the top. So I've got two instances of this. And it could have been, you know, dual imports, or I imported a whole collection that had this same game. But this is going to let us know that we do have two instances of this imported into LaunchBox. And finally, we've actually seen some people ask about this. You can export to an Excel spreadsheet. It's pretty easy to do. We're going to highlight the first one here. Control A. We've selected all of these games. Control C to copy everything. I'm just using an online Excel spreadsheet. Control V. And now we can export this. But these are some cool things built into the audit feature we have in LaunchBox. But yeah, this comes in really handy. And of course, you can do it per platform like we saw in this video. Or from tools at any time, we can actually go to Audit, All Games. Now it could take a little while to populate your collection here, depending on how fast your PC is and how many games you have. But it'll give us a list of every single game that we have imported into LaunchBox. So yeah, it's very easy to use the audit feature in LaunchBox. It can be a bit time consuming if you've got a lot of games that need to be audited. You can use the bulk edit wizard if you need to do it that way. But this is great for weeding out those problematic games or some games that may have been named incorrectly or just didn't catch the correct LaunchBox Games database ID. But that's going to wrap it up for this one. Really appreciate you watching. If you have any questions, let us know in the comments below. Definitely keep an eye on the YouTube channel and the LaunchBox forum because we've got a lot more coming. And like always, thanks for watching.